And you said it was like fire around the brim, burning solid beneath in the burning rim, like stars burning holes right through the dark, flicking fire like so into my.
Tell you I'm afraid of death, waiting at the pearly gates with a bated breath. Terrifies me if heaven exists, I'm dying to wait at my grand entrance, but nobody's replying. If it's real, then maybe I should repent for the people that I have crossed and the lifestyle I've kept. And if it's real, then maybe I should accept the fact that I'll be rejected for everything that I've said. I've broken many hearts and harbored hella hate. In many stages, I tear you instead of elevate. I stuck with vanity, having me trying to validate my presence, had me pressing my dressing without the salad plate. Let us ponder this. Why I sponsor these thoughts that were so preposterous? Went into logic hits, and logically I should have skipped on the hostile grip on life, cold to the bone, corroded fossil tips. Maybe people will miss me when this is posthumous, eager to see my coffin kiss the dirt that I have frolicked in. Through dissection and injection of collagen, maybe they see me different when nothing's stereotypic. All in all, I am surely now proud of many life choices I've made. I'll figure out how to cope with the guilt I have built. I'll shed my skin even though I know I'll never re-begin.
And you said,
stress over a lifted spirit. Made my bed and I sleep in it cause it gives me clearance. But I want more in this way, you're seeing a slimmed appearance. Living fearless is fine, but you're never bulletproof. I take it serious now that I've seen the light. At the end of the tunnel, I have consumed it too. Now what's inside of me waiting to ignite? My biggest fear is I'll never reach where I'm destined. Know my capabilities, I just need to accept them. Running away from destiny doesn't require steps. In fact, it requires nothing aside from staying where you're kept. I've oppressed myself, so offensive help. I start screaming it out, but nobody hears the shouts. And they're busy walking their path, creating futures that'll loosen up the burdens they shoulder. Do not feel stupid. Wasn't trying, just recycling the game. But being outspoken can break the bicycle frame. And there really ain't a point to having drive if the real man rather leave it idle till it dies. Every step now is vital to my lines, giving purpose that I'm just redefining every time that I step out the door after shedding my skin. Even though I know I'll never re-begin.
And you said,
this is Tina, and you're about to see this thing I did like a year ago about my album Playing Pug. And if you're interested in hearing the full thing, you can find it on streaming services like Bandcamp and stuff. So here it is. Thank you. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to remaster Plain Pug, an album I did back in 2009, 2016, right now. You do the math. And I'm going to go back to that time, try to remember what I wanted to do, and execute it in a way I could never have before. Recorded most of the tracks around 2000. From a very long time. And I didn't know I was making an album back then. But then it occurred to me that I had a lot of songs I've recorded on my computer, so I might as well put the ones I thought were the best into one album, and that was Plain Pug. I had decided to call it that, and I officially finished it, I thought, around 2009. I didn't think about it for years. I went on to do other albums, S.O. Nurture, and Falcon. I do have to say, it's nice to be reunited with her. Especially that song. What are you thinking?
will come from
Okay, the joke is over.
This is our company! It's Tina!